Good morning. Love my Great Danes, but they do slobber when they drink. I love pulling up to the job site first thing in the morning, talking to the guys, saying what's up, see how their night was, and then we start to develop a plan for the day. I've already thought about it all night, but then, you know, I talk to them, get their ideas, and then it's off to the races. We get our materials. We try to be efficient, so we bring stuff, you know, prep stuff, get it where we want it. And I'm going to be starting right away on the soffit. Greg is going to be starting on that ceiling under there. He's getting that area trimmed out. Our steel just showed up the morning that we started. Got there early. And usually I like to use a lift for soffit fascia, but when you're on a porch, it's kind of an awkward height. Really no good way of doing it with the lift because your rails are all right at that exact height, so you're just kind of always in the way. I don't like ladders that much. I'd rather set up a plank, but I don't really carry planks, so sawhorses it is. Usually I use a soffit gun. Pazload makes a pretty sweet shingle gun that shoots a great shingle nail for soffits. I really like that, but it was a little bit too cold that morning for some reason, and it was not shooting. So, hand drives. Cutting up some F&J trim. The F&J accepts steel on the bottom and soffit on the side, as you can see as I'm installing this soffit. And then we'll put side steel into the bottom later. We like to punch our steel. It gives us a nice straight line. You can see there's the whole pile of steel there is for this ceiling that Greg's working on. So basically, when you make those marks, you punch it through, it puts a spot on that steel where you're going to put all your screws, which creates a nice straight laser line, which is super important to us. No one likes doing ceilings, but I love the way they turn out when they're finished. Once again, look at all that ladder work. It just makes me cringe. I hate ladders. Up and down. On the outside there, prepping for roof steel, getting our drip edge on, putting the fascia on. Once your roof is obviously sheeted, it's where it's going to be, so you got to make sure when you do that, you're square. And if you do that, by the time it comes time to lay out your steel, it'll just go lickety-split, hit your three-foot marks. It's perfect. Once again, this steel was all punched on the ground, so when it goes up on the roof, there's no guessing where you're supposed to be screwing, and you're going to get a nice straight line. Not many people are going to be up on that roof to see it, but I saw it. It's like a machine gun there. Milwaukee Surge. And I didn't have any tennis shoes in my truck, but I had my penny loafers. Look at those lines. Ceiling done. Soffits done. Roof done. Time for side steel. If you guys are doing much steel work, get yourself a set of nibblers. These are the cordless Makitas. Couldn't live without them. It does a really nice job making clean cuts, too. And I use the double cut Milwaukee shears. First piece of steel is actually a little bit difficult because we've got to get into those two window trims that's going around those two windows. And also at the same time, go around the J channels that are on the porch. There's a lot of kind of manipulating of the steel to make that all work. But once that is done, you're kind of good to go above the porch and you're good to go below the porch. Pretty easy cuts, and all of our windows have already been cut out since we did this work already. Here I'm making one of the trims that go around the headers that attach to the building. It's kind of a pain in the butt just because it's a lot of cutting, a lot of marking, bending. But in the end, you know, it's all about the finishes. So take your time, do it right. Make sure you got nice cuts, nice bends, and you'll be happy with it. So will the customer. So right there in the front of the lift where that post meets the wall, that's what I was J-channeling around. This piece of steel is the hardest piece of steel on the job, though. Not only do we have to get into those J-channels around the porch, get around the soffit with that cut, but then we have to go underneath the steel on the right around both of those windows, top and bottom. But we got it. A little bit of steel manipulation, no problem. And the last thing to do is put on some porch angle braces. To me, probably, you know, that nice finishing touch that just says, all right, we're done. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this video as much as I did making it, specifically the building. I love post frames. I love, you know, I guess the craft, the trade. If you guys want to leave me any comments, suggestions on how I could maybe do the next video or ways to improve, I would gladly listen. And if you feel so inclined, subscribe to my channel. I'd appreciate it so you can see my next videos. We're constantly doing more post-frame buildings, a lot more houses as it's coming. I've got a couple coming down the pipes. And yeah, I appreciate you watching.